Our ability to store memories and build on them is a key component of a mammalian life, one that certainly served our early ancestors well. But it's easy to see that memories aren't physically stored and we don't physically retrieve them. Then what exactly does it mean to remember? Researchers think that synaptic plasticity, our brain's ability to adapt by changing the strength of connections between its neurons, is one of the processes behind memory.
But like anything in the field of modern neuroscience, it wasn't long ago when how we learn was completely ambiguous.
In 1949, Canadian psychologist Donald Hebb published his famed Hebb's postulate, often summarized as neurons that fire together, wire together, creating neural pathways. Still, it wasn't until 1973 that the biochemical mechanisms for this wiring were discovered. This process of long-term potentiation, or the ability to strengthen neural connections, was first observed in the rabbit hippocampus by Turi Lomo and Timothy Bliss. They found that administering frequent shocks created a greater response in neural pathways. Neurons are stimulated by the charges of ions, but ions can't cross the synapse. Instead, neurons send neurotransmitters to carry on the signal. The amino acid glutamate is our brain's most common neurotransmitter used to excite the receiving neuron. NMDA and AMPA are glutamate's two main ionotropic receptors, doors made of proteins that open when a messenger binds, letting in certain ions. Notably, the NMDA receptors let in calcium. When a neuron fires a signal down its axon, glutamate is released from its axon terminal and binds the receptors on the next neuron. The AMPA receptors open immediately, but movement through NMDA is blocked by a positively charged magnesium ion. So a brief review of your flashcard will only open AMPA receptors, but repeated review will cause your neurons to fire multiple times, releasing more glutamate, resulting in a greater influx of positive sodium ions, enough to repel the magnesium block in the NMDA receptor via electrostatic forces. Finally, calcium will be allowed in the cell and triggers a series of changes. These changes help the two neurons communicate more easily, mainly by activating an enzyme called CAMK2, which creates more AMPA receptors and increases their sensitivity. So next time, the same amount of glutamate release will have a larger response, explaining why your memory seems to improve with repetition. But this process, dubbed early phase LTP, seems to wear off after a few hours. Late phase LTP is induced with repeated stimulation over longer periods. It's hypothesized this involves persistent activation of enzymes which activate the protein Krebs. Krebs acts in the nucleus to switch on genes, many of which code for neurotrophic factors, creating memories that could last a lifetime. But not all learning experiences are positive. Traumatic memories or learned behaviors are often involved in mental illness and addiction. Insights into the mechanisms behind memory could explain these stigmatized concepts and enable artificial manipulation of synaptic plasticity. LTP is not a definite explanation for memory. One field of study can't even begin to define the complexities of human nature, but it's this very process of neuroplasticity that allows us to strive for a deeper understanding of the plentiful unknowns in the world around us.